Well, welcome back to the interview of Roger Joseph Manning Jr. My name is Willie Wisely, also known as Wisely. We're now label mates on Oglio Records, and I've had the pleasure of interviewing him here today with my questions. Now I wanted to, in advance of our interview, I collected some questions from people who enjoy my music and asked them what questions they would have for Roger. And I'll just poke some of these at him, and we'll see how the man does.
Yeah.
Andy Sullivan from Silver Springs, Maryland writes, "What is your favorite chord and why?" Love it.
Damn, good question.
Andy's a fan, so this is I think this is not a sarcastic exercise.
Wow, it's hard to narrow it down to one because they all
if Spinal Cat Tap can answer this question, why can't
That's
you?
That's the thing. I should have a very witty, comedic answer. I'm taking it way too seriously. What's my favorite chord?
What is your favorite chord and why? You can also say skip that question.
That would be A major, right? I would have to say a suspended chord.
Okay.
I'll play one. Basically, I don't even know why it's called a suspended chord anymore. Well, because
there's tension in it.
Tension in it, right? Yeah. And there are it wants resolution. So if I'm in the key of G, and I play like the four chord, which is C. And then I play the five chord, harmonically, it always wants to lead back to the one or the G. Back to the one chord. So so very often on that five chord, you can suspend it and create even more tension. So, four, five, and suspend it.
Spending it with a nine or with a four?
Okay. Both. All right? We have a nine, four, and even flat seven. Now the thing is with this chord is you can make entire vocabularies out of it. So you can keep you can run a series of suspended chords. So you can do stuff like I like the limbo kind of element of it, and you can from there you can
speaking of Herbie Hancock is that
yeah we start getting into total jazz at that point, but you can, in my opinion, you can tastefully weave these.
I thought I heard Maiden Voyage.
Well, that's part of it.
I'm sorry.
I mean,
keep going.
Absolutely. Maiden Voyage is a suspended song, you know. Right?
Uh-huh.
It's not a suspension.
You got to get the Bird and the Bee record and the Herbie Hancock record now.
But when this stuff gets tastefully weaved in and out of a 3.5 minute classic pop song, I just find it incredibly gratifying because they are just like having a cool guitar tone that you've sculpted with a lot of different pedals or something, and your combination of vintage amps or some unique synth keyboard sound that you and the engineer have spent 2 days processing and sculpting because you just wanted it to be something you'd never heard before. You can make use of chord vocabulary that way. And So why not? I mean, it just ends up happening that way.